What we need is inheritance, and that's a way to reuse classes to build new classes. So what we wanted to do was define these two new types, main dish and appetizer, and both of these are types of dishes. That means if we had a dish type, well, we could create the main dish type by specializing the dish type, and we could create an appetizer type by also specializing the dish type. This is called inheritance. We would say main dish inherits from dish. There's lots of terminology that goes along with this. We would say the main dish inherits from dish, and that's what these up arrows in our diagrams mean. If we look at it in the other direction, we would say main dish and appetizer are both subclasses of dish. And we would say dish is the base class or superclass of main dish and appetizer. There's a lot of different terminology people use to talk about this. But the important thing to understand is that we're building these subclasses, main dish and appetizer, which are special types of dishes, by starting from the dish type and adding some extra behavior to it. We can keep going. We could have a new derived class based on the appetizer class, and then the Pythonic appetizer would inherit from appetizer. It would also inherit from dish, and these subclass terms are transitive. So Pythonic appetizer is a subclass of appetizer. It's also a subclass of dish. How does this look in code? Well, if you remember, when we introduced the class syntax, we said there was this base class as part of the class definition. So far, we've used object for all of our base classes, but the base class can be any other type. So to get what we've shown here, we would have the main dish have as its base class the dish, and then the definition of the main dish class, and we would have the appetizer have as its base class the dish, and the Pythonic appetizer has as its base class the appetizer. What about the dish? Well, we didn't draw any base class for that, and its base class is object. That's the ultimate superclass of all classes we create in Python.